If 2021 were a kind of food, it would be the durian fruit, the stinkiest fruit on the planet. But there's one thing worse than an everyday durian, and that's a rotten one. We're going to talk about many things today, from serial killers to NASA's efforts to take out a killer asteroid, but we can't ignore the topic of a certain virus. So let's start with that. The Economist published an article the other day that said COVID-19 is likely to fade away in 2022. But if you look at what the magazine said a year ago, it was that the COVID-19 pandemic will be over by the end of 2021. It ain't over till the fat lady sings, as the saying goes. And as things stand right now, a new strain of the virus with a name that sounds like a transformer is on the scene. The question is, how many more strains will we have to endure in the future? As we write this, the World Health Organization is telling us that the Omicron variant of the virus has a high risk of infection on a global scale. So much for the pandemic easing up by the end of 2021. It probably seems to many of you that just when you're getting comfortable and thinking you're seeing the end of the apocalyptic headlines, you get hit over the head with something new. Living through the COVID-19 pandemic is like starring in Groundhog Day. It's frankly depressing when late in 2021 you read the BBC website and see The Who saying things like, COVID-19 is not done with us. Omicron has an unprecedented number of spike mutations, some of which are concerning for their potential impact on the trajectory of the pandemic. Will it ever let up? It seems not just yet. With The Who saying earlier this year that once the Greek alphabet has been exhausted, it might start naming new variants after constellations of stars. There are only 24 letters in the Greek alphabet, but there are 88 constellations. Maybe if we run out of them, we can start naming new variants after stars, of which there are only around 200 billion just in our galaxy, although most of them aren't officially named. One scientist said the virus will get weaker over time, saying there's a limited amount of genetic variation that a virus genome can withstand and still remain easily transmitted. He said, in other words, a bottleneck will occur, and then during genome replication, it'll weaken. That's the good news. But the bad news is that it seems when the end of the year comes around, we will still be dealing with variants that could be dangerous enough to have the government announce more lockdowns. That in mind, we are sorry to inform you that social distancing, mask wearing, and even lockdowns are more than possible for next year. We know what getting the virus does to the body, but how will lockdowns and distancing and general COVID stress affect us next year? We promise we'll talk about the lighter topic of world-ending killer asteroids soon. More bad news means more stress. This year, numerous news media were publishing stories with headlines similar to this one. U.S. adults report highest stress levels since early days of the COVID-19 pandemic. And what does prolonged stress do to the body? It weakens our immune systems, can lead to heart disease, high blood pressure, as well as depression and anxiety. And what do some people do to deal with such stress? Many of them turn to drugs and alcohol. As we said last year, the news media reported an increase of drug abuse in the USA during the first lockdowns. That includes legal drugs too, such as alcohol. In August this year, the BBC reported pandemic alcohol abuse linked to depression rise. The article said, people were using alcohol as a means to cope with the lockdown. The lockdowns not only have caused an increase in deaths as a result of liver-related diseases in the UK by 21%, but have also had immeasurable damage on the mental well-being of everyone. So, unfortunately, what damage has been caused by lockdowns will present itself next year or over the following years. And because the stress of COVID is here to stay for a while, it's possible that much more damage will be done. It's not just the Brits who are feeling the weight of COVID, though. In October this year, an article in The Lancet said, we estimate an additional 53.2 million cases of major depressive disorder globally, an increase of 27.6% due to the COVID-19 pandemic. The pandemic has not only created new problems, but is making already existing problems worse. Earlier in the year, the media was saying the billionaires of the world got 54% richer, just as most of everyone else was suffering the hardships of the pandemic. The World Bank in 2021 said COVID has caused rising poverty and widening inequality on a global scale. It said the poorest have been hit the worst and they haven't recovered what they've lost, while the people just above have recovered a bit but are still on the losing side of average. One of the billionaires who had done well during the pandemic is Bill Gates, a man who'd been locked down at times in one of his palatial estates that had a total value of $170 million. He recently announced that we will get the pandemic under control, but it won't be until at least the summer of 2022. Still, he said people will be dying from COVID in smaller numbers all year. It sucks to be poor, and we doubt 2022 will suddenly see a change in inequality. It will be another year in which we see the effects of job loss, savings loss, and general standard of living loss, which, as you all know, can lead to mental health issues as well as sickness and instability in families. Some people turn to crime when life has kicked them in the face more than once. One of the things we've seen a worrying rise in is cybercrime. The FBI has said this all seems to have been a trend during the pandemic, stating that from 2020 to 2021, it saw an increase of 1 million cybercrime events. Think about it. More people have been thrust into poverty. Meanwhile, during the lockdowns, more folks have been doing more things online, such as buying stuff and doing their banking. Not to mention the increased number of people working from home and inputting sometimes sensitive data into their not-so-secure computers. It's the perfect storm. The FBI said the top crimes are online scams, saying scammers have been exploiting the COVID-19 pandemic. Be assured, this will likely get worse in 2022. Interpol had this to say about the rise in cybercrime. Cybercriminals are developing and boosting their attacks at an alarming pace, exploiting the fear and uncertainty caused by the unstable social and economical situation created by COVID-19. Staying with technology, has the pandemic helped push us further into a kind of Orwellian dystopia where Big Brother watches over us? Human Rights Watch warns us that governments might exploit the pandemic to instate authoritarian rule, saying that we might be walking into a kind of surveillance reality of unprecedented scale and intrusiveness. While the USA has for the most part pushed back against the use of surveillance tech, such as facial recognition software, the authorities want it very much. Other countries such as China and Russia have already been using this tech to monitor folks in the name of stopping the spread of the virus. But of course, monitoring us and telling us where we can and can't go might be for the greater good of mankind. After all, we need to get a handle on this virus. Nonetheless, in terms of general well-being, people don't usually like being tracked and traced and told where to stay all the time. As Human Rights Watch says, any deployment of technology should be rooted in human rights standards, centered on enabling people to live a dignified life. Let's face it, though, in 2022, even if you want to go to certain places in the world, there will likely be some added restrictions. Again, this is for the greater good, but it certainly can't be seen as a positive in terms of how we live. All of these problems will become much more insignificant if Earth is hit by a killer asteroid. And in October 2022, one of them is going to get close to Earth. Well, at least close in the astronomical sense. Its name is Didymos. While that sounds like a cute Japanese cartoon character, even the asteroid's small 500-foot-wide satellite moon Dimorphos would be capable of wiping out some of our cities if it struck the Earth. Luckily, you don't need to worry too much. Neither Didymos nor Dimorphos will ever come within 3.5 million miles of Earth, which is over 14 times the distance between the Earth and the Moon. But even though there's no chance this one will lead to our own extinction event, NASA is still testing out deflection technology options in case we detect one that could hit in the future. Earlier in the year, NASA launched something called the Double Asteroid Redirection Test, or DART, which was described by the New York Times as a 1,200-pound refrigerator that will intentionally collide with Dimorphos to change the asteroid's motion in space. This is a giant leap for mankind. As one scientist said, it's kind of a big milestone for our species, like the dinosaurs didn't have a DART mission. NASA says we don't have to be concerned about the mission going wrong. Apparently, even if it does, Earth should be okay. Since when DART makes its kinetic impact with Dimorphos, both the spacecraft and asteroid will be over 6 million miles away. But just knowing NASA is concerned enough about near-Earth objects or NEOs impacting us that they need to test our ability to knock them off course is a little bit terrifying, even if Didymos isn't going to be the one to wipe us off the planet. As for killers of the ordinary kind, you've all probably read the reports that said homicides were on the rise in various cities in the US in 2020. We don't know the numbers for 2021 just yet, but we might ask if this trend will continue, especially since we're told inequality and income loss has been on the rise. It seems murder was the crime that saw the major rise, as well as domestic violence, with many other rates of serious crime dropping. The data shows us that homicides weren't spreading out more, but that they were rising in number in places where they already were high homicide rates. Another very negative effect of the pandemic has been its impact on the rapid increase of homelessness across the globe. If homelessness wasn't already a huge problem in the USA, in 2021, the Seattle Times wrote an article stating a recession following the coronavirus pandemic could cause twice as much homelessness nationwide. It cited a study which said this pandemic-induced recession and mass loss of jobs could see homeless numbers go through the roof in 2022 and 2023. And if life wasn't hard enough for the homeless, they're often the prey for serial killers. Yeah, we haven't got rid of those folks yet. In fact, in 2021, some media reported that there are 4,000 unidentified serial killers dead or alive in the US, although only 50 living killers are active. These are the numbers given by something called the Murder Accountability Project. We guess the good thing about the increase in surveillance technology we use will be that those serial killers will have a much harder job getting away with it. Experts on serial killers have said perhaps some guys get arrested after their first murder these days, but in the past, such people might have gone on to make a name for themselves. With the pandemic decreasing the well-being of ourselves and our society, we can look forward to another year of decreasing living standards and possible world-ending events. 2022 might not be a great year just because the world is still shaking from something that first wobbled it back in 2019. Now, you need to watch Why Spanish Flu Killed Over 50 Million People, Deadliest Plague in Modern History, or feel a lot better about your current position with Cannibal Island, the real battle royale.